So on a sector by sector or industry by industry basis, where, in addition to retail, do you see the most risk of disruption?
Right. So we actually been spending much more of our time on the distressed side in Europe, not in the liquid credit markets either, because there's not so much distress in the market today, although you're starting to see more cracks in that market because of the European weakness. But again, that's 4%
fundamental economic.
Well, the economic recovery in Europe has been a lot slower, not just Brexit. If you look at the German and French PMIs, they're down. You know, it's funny to go back full circle for a second. We started the year, it was global synchronized growth, the tailwind of tax cuts, and now global synchronized growth doesn't feel there and the tax cuts we spent. So that's why, again, there's more anxiety. But in Europe, again, some of the capital goods companies are getting hurt. Some of the chemical companies are getting hurt. Where we're actually spending a lot of our time is on shipping, which has been a sector that a lot of people have, more people have lost money and been challenged by the sector. But we think there's an interesting opportunity today in some of the debt that the German banks in particular have been selling because it's closer to the maturity, and we think there's an opportunity to take the collateral, either that or work it out with the existing owner. There's real estate opportunities in Spain. Spain has actually been doing reasonably well. Italy is still challenged, and there's some selective opportunities that we're looking at, but that script is still being written.
What about across the channel? What if Theresa May can't get a Brexit deal done?
Well,
with her own parliament.
Sure.
Because she's now worked it out with the Europeans.
Well, for now, right? Look, I think that would be a seemingly to me an event that would cause some dislocation. Although it's been pretty remarkable, if you look at all the dislocating events over the last decade, people ended up buying and the market rallied back.
Which is why I ask. I mean, is that...
Yeah, look, I think the market, by and large, still expects there to be a deal. And if there truly was a hard Brexit that was devastating, I think the markets would react negatively.
Does that create opportunities for you?
Sure. No, look, the thing, you know, I joke around both internally and externally. I don't exactly know what I'm rooting for every day. You know, we ultimately want to make money for our investors. And so when the markets are performing well, we're excited about the beta and the alpha opportunity, which we think exists in good markets too. When the market is underperforming, we have the opportunity to use the distress capability that we've built up over 30 years to seize on the market. We have a very large distress fund that we raised 2 years ago that has billions of dollars of dry powder that we've been waiting on. A number of investors actually recently with us and with others have been setting up separate accounts that only take effect, the investment period starts when high yield spreads widen. So I think that if the market, if whether it's Brexit, whether it's a very troubling meeting between President Trump and President Xi, whether there's Italy issues, I think that if there's market opportunity, then you know we and our brethren have a lot of capital seizing that opportunity. There will be some who will be forced to sell or will choose to sell because of fear, and that's when often there's some very good opportunity.
What you're rooting for is overreaction.
Yeah, I think that overreaction is good, as long as you don't get swept in it yourself.